Greetings and welcome to Spiritual Magic Journey. This is your tarot card reading for the lovely sign of Scorpio for the month of June 2018. Hope everyone out there is doing well this month. At first, I'm going to pull a card from the Keepers of the Light Oracle deck just as an overview to see what's going on with Scorpio for the month of June. Then I'm going to pull a couple cards from the Witch's Tarot that'll help expand on that monthly card. And then I'm going to pull one from Postcards from Spirit to give a further special message or meaning to you. Let me get some smoke signals going over here in my... Pantol Sotol, holy wood. I just want to say, guys, thank you for liking, subscribing, and sharing these videos. If you'd like to get a reading with me, you can visit my brand new website at spiritualmagicjourney.com. Everything's in the description box. You can follow me on Facebook at Spiritual Magic Journey. Facebook. You can even write me. Yeah, my address is in the description. If you want to write a letter, shoot me some smoke signals, send me an email. Got questions, happy to answer them. You want to support what I'm doing here, you can support me through PayPal. Everything's in the description box, or cash me. So let's pull a card for Scorpio. Let's see what's going on for the month of June. Lovely Scorpios. Let's see, I was looking. Let's see what your main card was. For Scorpio. Oh, you got Lady Venus. Downloads and understanding. Truth is being revealed. Deep insights are coming from heaven and the astral realm. You see that, Lady Venus? Pretty awesome for you, Scorpio, this month of June. Downloads and understanding. So more meanings in your life, more knowing, more wisdom, more guidance. Pull a couple cards from Witch's Tarot. Says the truth is being revealed. Deep insights are coming from heaven and the astral realm. So more knowledge in the ether. Awesome. Understanding how things work. Maybe seeing things that others don't. Swing my bell. Gotta get back in the habit of things. So, let's see if we can expand on that. Been asking questions? You've been asking for knowledge, Scorpios? Wanting to know more? Wanting some guidance? But let's see, the karma here is the Judgment. Got the Queen of Cups. The Five of Swords. And the Lovers making decisions. You've got the Karma, which is a Judgment. It's like a final settlement in a matter. It's like having a clean slate. It's like a rebirth. You know, of starting over, especially if you wanted to start over somehow, or you wanted a second chance at something. You can say a second chance or a new life, something. It's like being resurrected. there's something new up on the horizon for you, and I think it's going to do with more with on the spiritual and the astral realm. Something new on the horizon. This is going to be a time for rejoicing and renewal. These three people, the mother, the father, and the child, are like doing solar. This is like a solar eclipse here. And it's, they're doing their solar magic in this card. But this is the judgment card, so, yeah. Some of you may be paying off old debts. But something new. And if it's anything to do with anything legal, it's going to be in your favor. It's always going to be in your favor when this card comes up. But it's just like a rebirth. Something new. Maybe some new understandings of how things work in the spiritual realm or the ether for some of you. We've got this Queen of Cups, and the Queen of Cups is you may know this person. This could be you that I'm just talking about. This is just a warm, loving person. Just full of joy. And she's got a very highly intuition. So that goes along with the Lady Venus card. Almost like a psychic. Very intuitive. Maybe visions coming to you guys, whether you're male or female, and this is just a general reading. Maybe visions coming to you, more intuition, more understanding, getting those downloads, deep insights is all the truth being revealed. Oh, I love it. It's all connecting. I see how it's all connecting here. You've also got this Five of Swords. And this is, this card usually represents some kind of discord or some kind of conflict. I think you're going to have small conflicts in your life. You're going to have to make a decision. I see the Lover's card here. It always reminds me, especially with the cards that's surrounding this, that you're going to have to make a decision. And I think it's got to do with this Five of Swords. It's not necessarily a defeat. Like some people want to say it, I don't see it as a defeat in this reading. I just think that you got to make a decision. There's some kind of conflict that's blocking you, that's stopping you from going down that road that you need to go down, which is understanding and getting those downloads from the higher realms and from the ether and, you know, that are coming from the astral realm and stuff like that. And you've got to make that decision of what you want to do. You see the angel right there in the back of the Lover's card. That are coming from, deep insights that are coming from heaven. As Lady Venus over their states. Thank you. But, yeah, I think you've got to make that decision. It's like you're getting what you want. Especially if you're on a spiritual path and you want to become a seer. You want to become that clairvoyance and clairaudience, and you've been working towards that, but there's something else. I don't know if something's keeping you in the 3D, because I feel like some of you are already vibrating on a higher dimension, on a higher frequency, Scorpios, and there's something that's weighing you, that's keeping you in the 3D. So you're gonna have to make your decision. I don't know if this has to do with someone, a love interest that maybe is not vibrating on the same frequency that you are. But you're gonna get more understandings with the, you know, more understandings and more truths being revealed, especially if you've been asking for truths to come forth. All you have to do is ask the universe and you will get those information that you need. Let's see what Postcards from Spirit wants to say to you. Scorpio, some more information, some more knowledge. Yeah, I don't know if it's another person, a mate, maybe, that is, like I said, is not on your frequency. It's not tuned in there yet. And that may be causing a little conflict. But I feel like the majority of you, the ones I'm talking to with this reading, this is just a general reading, are definitely vibrating high and you're on your path. Is with love. Let's see if I can hold it so you can read it and I can read it too. Hold it down a little bit. It says, dearest you, do you know how much we love you and want to help you? We are here for you and we hear you ask the guidance, but you must let go and let us help you. You don't have to do it all. You've done your part. Now let us do ours. You would be awestruck if you knew how many strings we poured through the matrix to give you what you need and desire. Spirit has a plan, and when you sign up to be a co-creator, you need to remember to allow the partnership. It's not one-sided. Your desires and plans meet up with those of the spirit. Remember, through Spirit's timetable and ideals of how things will play out may be quite different from yours. Trust us. Pay attention to other areas of your life, and before you know it, a miracle will have taken place. We love you so much. Oh, that is pretty awesome for you guys, Scorpio. I love each and every one of you. I hope this helps you in your journey through life. Blessings, my friends, and namaste.